Oh, hello. You know what time it is? It's time to blow some glass. So, today we are going to make a Fumicello pendant. First, we need our scallop tubing. Take a look at the inside there. Isn't it pretty? All of those will help us get the pattern that we want. Next, we've got our two magic wands. One of them with some silver on the tip of it. Let's see if that'll get into focus for you. Come on, you can do it. I believe in you. There we go, there's the silver. And another one with a little piece of gold on it. That's gonna help us out. Come on, you know, show that gold. You can do it. I believe in you, camera. There we go. There's that gold. So, while doing this, I'll be using some tools. We have a small octagonal reamer, a large octagonal reamer, as well as a graphite rod. Yep, it's just a rod of graphite. And on top of that, I like to measure things. Since I'm doing it for you folks on Imgur, I've got my measuring tool right here. Oh yeah, banana for scale, you know it. So, let's turn on our fan. Proper ventilation is very important. Nothing like getting the glass blower lungs. Second, you need your glasses. I'm sorry I don't have a filter yet, but I'll be getting there soon. Let's turn on our bench burner. First, we're gonna turn on the propane. Throw on some oxygen. And now let's get the outside flame to clear out the burner, any dust that might happen to be in there. All right, so first thing I'm gonna do is clean off the glass. It's very important. Dirty glass stays on there for the whole time and just leaves little itty bitty bubbles. Not any fun. So let's clean this off. There we go. Nice and clean. So what I'm going to do is pop open the front of this, flare it open, and then attach a blow handle to it, because I do not want to be using the entire piece of glass. Got a nice piece of 4mm rod here. Just pop it open. Here is a blow handle that I'm going to attach and cut off about half of a banana worth of glass. I'll show you that later. Apologize if I'm not talking a lot. I have a bit of strep throat right now. Getting a lot better. But my voice is a little bit scratchy, so I might have to take a drink now and then. And I apologize for the sound quality. I haven't quite got a microphone either. So we'll just be using the camera's mic. Sorry about that all. A little bit. Blow that out. Some people like to just knock it off, but for me, I find it a little easier just to clean it up with a nice rod.
little less messy.
But do whatever you want to do. And some of you glass blowers out there might notice my flame is a little bit interesting quality of color. Part of that is due to the fact that I am using an HVO system as opposed to liquid or compressed oxygen. I've been using it for 3 years. You love that thing. I highly recommend them. The one thing you'll notice is that your flame is a little bit cooler than it would be if you're using liquid or compressed oxygen. Now, let's connect these two with a nice seal here. Both sides nice and warm. All right, and connect. Melt in. There we go. I'll make it prettier in a minute. Now, as I said, let's see here, about half the 6 centimeters on the banana. That's about right there. All right. Need to let it melt down too much because it'd be easier just to open it up by pulling it. But it's keeping it thin, just like that. Pretty is not important at this point. We'll make it pretty in a minute. This is just to make sure everything's nice and clean. Tap the rod here in the center. Nice and centered there. Now let's melt in the back side here so that we don't have any stress. Just like in life, stressing glass is not exactly the thing you want all the time. A little bit is okay, but too much, it just breaks. All nice and cleaned up. Even melt on it. Nice airflow, full of fume inside. Nice and centered. Okay. And now let's open up the front of this. We'll get the pretty later. So, grab the carbon rod. Graphite is nice. It doesn't stick. Doesn't leave junk behind. Is the opening big enough? That looks pretty good. Okay. Now, in order to get the silver and gold to stick, we need to get everything all nice and warm. Which means our hand is going to get burned a little bit because we need to have the fume go all the way through. At least for a little bit. So, get nice and warm inside the glass. Ooh, that it's toasty. Now, let's get ourselves a nice flame there. Warm up the gold a bit so it doesn't pop off. We're going to just get the tiniest bit of gold in there. Just enough to help clean up any issues we have with the silver. Just smidgeable, just the littlest bit. You don't see any pink in there, just the littlest bit, that's all you need. Now we're gonna warm it up, get a little bit of a nice orange to the clear glass, so the silver will stick nicely. And I know everybody likes to fume differently. Everybody's got a different heat spot they like it. So I'm not gonna tell you what's right or what's wrong. Do the way that works for you. But you wanna make sure that you got at least everything warm enough to accept the silver. I like a fairly propane-rich flame where I work it back. That way I don't burn the crap out of my hands so much. This part's gonna take a while. See, it's starting to get a little bit of a nice yellow. This is the silver stain. Gotta keep it warm so it keeps accepting that silver. You don't wanna have any of the flame that has too much propane in it, so you don't want oxygen if you put it inside this way, otherwise it'll change the color. Silver. That's nice and warm. So using a different kind of burner will take less time, but I like using this one because even though it takes a little bit more time, I'm able to control the amount of silver that I put in it a lot better. It's toasty. Starting to get pretty nice looking. Get it all nice and warm again. Let's let the silver soak in a couple more times. Make sure we get enough dark aspect of the silver. Once again, if you're using a different burner, it's going to look different. bit better. Let's see how much it's going to disappear now. So the disappearing is where it's absorbing more oxygen, which is allowing it to go throughout the matrix of the glass. I know, lots of information, but hey, what can you do? Probably the last time we got nothing there. Have any of the flame shoot inside of the glass. I'm going to slowly let it gather itself a little bit thicker. Don't mind the beast over there. It's what creates all the oxygen, as I said. Absolutely wonderful device.
see the lines.
Give me a second, I'll bring it up closer to the camera. down, so maybe a little, just a little puff, nothing else, not too bad. Make sure it's in the center. I'm gonna get right here real close. You can see that. Come on, you got it. Come on, camera. There we go. Really close. That's got barely even a millimeter of space there. So the next part, I'm gonna do about halfway down the glass. And once again, you don't want to keep spinning it faster with the same hand you did the last one. So I spin it faster with this hand than this one, which will give it a bit of a spiral. But we'll finish the spirals off later on. So this part just takes a bit of time. I prefer a softer flame working in the oxygen-rich part of the environment or toward the neutral, either one you'd like, but not so much in the reducing area yet. I tend to use the kiln to strike the silver more often than not.
Thank you.
Okay. Ran out of batteries. So, I got that going again. Slowly heated up. It didn't take too long to change the battery. But anyway, get it warmed up really quick and I'll show you what hopefully I didn't miss. See how it's got a nice spiral all the way across. Same there on the front part too. All right, now we're gonna do a Maria. I'm gonna start on the front one, which is this side. Nice, sharp flame. We're gonna put it right down the middle of the bubble. And push. And when you start pushing, you don't wanna stop, otherwise it'll show up on where the silver touches. Really helps that everything is nicely centered when you start this. Start pushing. Pushing, and just trying to keep the heat in that one spot, and then slowly go all the way down. So. Now, we're going to do the next one. They make sure an original one to clean it up. You don't want any stress there to get trapped. You've got a little bit of a frosted look. Heat it up, let it cool down a little bit. Slowly warm up your back bubble. And once again, right in the center of the bubbles where you keep your flame. You have to watch it as you're pushing because you don't want to trap air in between the two planes that you're creating. I kind of wish I had a GoPro so I could have it directly on my head so you could see exactly what I see. The over the shoulder is kind of nice, but I'm not quite getting exactly what's happening. You get most of it. Now, don't worry too much if you have some air bubbles, which I'll show you, or some air that hasn't been completely pushed out. We'll fix that. Make sure you clean off the front, which is eventually going to be the back of this. Yes. you can see there's a little bit of air still there. So we're going to heat it from this side back, and that way the air gets pushed out. Maybe there might be a little air bubble in the middle, but it still looks pretty cool. So, you can heat up here. Let's let everything sort of melt back. That the air is slowly getting pushed out as the glass condenses down. Pretty good. Almost all the air out.
I got all the air out of the backside bubble that's now not a bubble. Melting in. This is the slow parts of it. Thank you. still need a little bit of marble mold to help me. Such little air in there, I don't have to worry about pulling it all the way up. I'll get everything all nice and hot and just give it a little bit of pull and try and get it all the way up. There we go. Good enough. That'll look pretty. So now let's attach the rod here. It is pretty good. There we go. Seal does not be pretty good, so I'm cleaning off a good portion of that anyway. Up the front of it, because this now has become the front. Not too much though, because I'm doing a lot more cleaning up later. Just going to stretch it out to a point that's centered. Okay, so I've got some Glass Alchemy Eclipse right here. Sometimes glass has air bubbles trapped in it for the color when you buy it. So what I'm going to do is I usually cut off a small piece cleanly and just barely heat it up at first and attach another piece of clear to it. Work it in a nice oxygen-rich environment, slowly work it back this way to pull out as much of the air as possible in the glass so you don't get air bubbles trapped. Some colors you want air bubbles, that's fine. With a nice black background, the air bubbles will show up, and then it's not so pretty.
that. You can see it's kind of yellowish right now. A little bit of a blue hue you can see because it's transmitting the glass, the light as opposed to reflecting it. So now we put a black on it.
There, you can't rip.
Oh. Can't really see that all right. Let's try to fill it better on. Oh, there. And you can kind of see the blue. I think you'll see it afterwards. So, I'm going to put this on a background. I like to use Eclipse because it doesn't have chromium in it. Less chance of getting a haze and get a nice true black background. main reason I'm changing the flame is not the chemistry of the flame, it's just how much of it I want to heat up. And every time you change the flame, you gotta change position where you have it. So you don't mess up the chemistry of the flame as well. Yeah.
Out of the
through the middle.
There you go, now get a hole.
Flatten the back side so it sits nice against the chest.
Since this one is basically solid, yeah, it does have that little air bubble in the middle.
Should still be okay.
Subject. Thank you, everybody, for watching. Bye bye.